Let's see how to make a variable change at a certain rate per second. This has countless applications. For example, fade the screen, lower the volume gradually, counting time, making movements with precision, but in this case we will see just a generic example. In the corner you have a link to my website where you can download this Unity package I'm using in case you're interested. And for more videos like this, make sure to click that subscribe button below. So, we have a script that is assigned to the camera. Here we are seeing its parameters in the inspector, and in the scene we only have a text in the canvas. We're gonna use it to show the value that we will change over time. The variable that we're gonna modify over time is this one, and we're gonna do it both in the update method and in the fixUpdate method. For that, I included this boolean variable, useFixedUpdate. This allows us to decide if we make the change in one method or the other. Here in the corner, I leave you an experiment to understand the difference between update and fixUpdate. This is the instruction to change the variable over time. Notice that both in update and fixUpdate, I'm using exactly the same instruction. And what we do is take the variable we wanna modify and make it an increment. Here, the plus equal operator is gonna take all this part and add it to the stored value in the variable. And in the right part, we are multiplying two things. One is what is known as the rate of change, or the amount that the variable changes per second in this particular case. And the other part is a time factor. Time.deltaTime, as you can read here in the message, gives us the time that passed since the last frame. And if you use it inside a fixUpdate function, it will give you the fixed time step, which by default is 20 milliseconds. I will print these messages in the console, debug.log, time.deltaTime. I will do it in the update method and in the fixUpdate method. Look, I enter the play mode. Notice that here in the console, the time 0.02 is printed. If I uncheck this box, the update method will be used, and now we see that the console message has changed and it's showing the time between frames, but with fixUpdate always shows 0.02. So, then we have this variable, which determines how much is the change over time. In this case is 1. If I enter the play mode, we see that the variable is changing by 1 unit per second, but if here we enter 5 for example, the change would be by 5 units per second. We can also use negative values to decrease this amount every second. And I think the most important thing here is that this rate of change is valid for both update function and fixUpdate function. To prove it, I duplicate this text, move it down here. I will also duplicate the script, copy the component and paste it as a new component. In the second script, I will drag the other text indicator and I will uncheck this box. Then this script will take care of writing the first text inside the fixUpdate function, and this other script will write the second text inside the update function. Enter the play mode and we see that the values match. To end the video, let's remove the decimals from the indicator. Here, in the instruction where I'm writing the text on the screen, this is the variable that we write. I will add the word int between parentheses. This is called typecasting, and it will convert this value, which is a float, to an integer. Save the script, enter the play mode, and this would be the result. That's all I wanted to show you. I hope you find it useful. Subscribe for more videos like this, and see you next time.